The ComponentOne PDF Viewer control can be used to display Adobe PDF documents in your WPF and Silverlight applications. In this video, I will show you how to get started using the C1 PDF Viewer control and cover the basic customization options available to you. After you have installed Studio for WPF or Studio for Silverlight, you should find the C1 PDF Viewer control in your toolbox. Drag an instance of the control to your page, resize it, and name the control so that we can later access it in CodeBehind. By default, you will notice that the PDF Viewer control for WPF and Silverlight has a built-in toolbar. This houses all of the commands from which users can save, print, navigate, zoom, and search documents. You can hide the built-in toolbar by setting the toolbar visibility property to hidden. We've also added an Open File button, which is disabled by default. To enable this button, set the Open Button Visibility property to Visible. Without needing to write any code, we now have a fully functional PDF Viewer application. I will also set the Background property to Gray, and then launch the application. At runtime, users can open a PDF from their computer if you've enabled the Open button. They can navigate the document by scrolling or using the toolbar to perform other actions. Next, let's look at the common scenario of loading an existing document from the application. For this, I will jump to my CodeBehind. You'll notice that I've already added a PDF to my project's resources directory and set its build action to embedded resource. So now I can obtain a stream to this file by calling assembly.getManifestResourceStream. Then once I have a stream, I can pass it to the PDF viewer's loadDocument method. Note that you can also use a file path to load a document rather than a stream. I will go ahead and set the view mode property here in code. I've chosen fit width so the document will be fitted to match the client window upon initial load. Notice that the C1 PDF viewer will display any PDF file, and properties such as page orientation and margins are defined in the document itself. For more advanced PDF work, we also provide the ComponentOne PDF library for generating files. You'll find more Getting Started videos like this one in our video library at our.componentone.com.